Hi, everyone. I'm Kevin Nelson. Here's a look at what's going on this week in the news. We begin with news from the Vatican. The Vatican has announced that Pope Francis will not be traveling to South Sudan in the near future. The Pope had wanted to visit the country to highlight the millions of people facing violence, displacement, chronic hunger, and mass starvation, and to nudge conflicting parties toward peace. However, because of the volatile situation in the country, the Pope has decided not to go at this time. But although he is not going to be there in person, he is sending some much-needed aid to the area. Rum Reports has more from the Vatican.
Pope Francis will not travel to South Sudan, but he still wants to be present. As such, he will allocate almost $500,000 to support three projects carried out by Religious and Caritas.
As you know, the Holy Father met the religious leaders of South Sudan here at a meeting with View, at which they invited him to visit. Subsequently, he planned to visit, and when the conditions, you know, were so deteriorated that he couldn't visit, that's when this project comes.
One of the projects is dedicated to the training of future teachers, another to support 2,500 farming families, and the last to help two hospitals. Sister Laura Geminiani works at one of these medical centers in South Sudan. She describes a chilling experience. I once saw a man beheaded near the hospital, 10 meters away. Unfortunately, it did not make the news as if it were a normal thing. This is one of the greatest dangers that happens to you when you're a missionary. You become accustomed. It's important for people to feel that we will not leave them. We are not only there for one project and then we leave. Many times we've been told, they're all gone. They have escaped. Above all, NGOs are here for a short time. But you have never abandoned us. This is what we want. South Sudan is one of the poorest countries in the world. Civil war and hunger ruthlessly hit the civilian population. In February, humanitarian organizations gave the alarm. 100,000 people were at risk of imminent starvation. In July, this problem could be extended to 1 million.
Looking now at news from around the country, Baltimore Archbishop William Laurie celebrated Mass June 21st at the Basilica of the National Shrine of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary to open the U.S. Bishop's Fortnight for Freedom. The Mass was being held on the vigil of the feast day of English martyrs St. John Fisher and St. Thomas More. The Archbishop in his homily said that these saints fulfilled their mission of bearing witness to Christ in their time, their place, their circumstances. The Archbishop went on to say to the congregation that they were gathered in prayer, asking to acquire in the power of the Holy Spirit a greater measure of holiness so that they too can use their freedom not for themselves and their own desires, but rather for Christ and the mission of spreading the gospel far and wide. The Fortnight for Freedom is the annual observance highlighting the importance of religious liberty. It will end July 4th. Archbishop Laurie will celebrate another Fortnight Mass July 3rd in Orlando, Florida, for the convocation of Catholic leaders. More news from the Vatican. Members of the NFL Hall of Fame, including soon-to-be-inducted Dallas Cowboys owner Jerry Jones, met with Pope Francis at the Vatican this past week. The Pope talked about the values of teamwork, fair play, and the pursuit of excellence, and how these values or virtues are not only needed on the field, but off the field as well, to build a culture of encounter. Rum Reports has more on this special meeting.
Pope Francis was greeted to a warm round of applause by members of the NFL's Hall of Fame delegation, with many donning their official jackets in this private meeting. Among those present were household names such as Jerry Jones, Franco Harris, and Ronnie Lott. Joking that he was an avid follower of football, but of a different kind, the Pope highlighted the role that professional athletes have on society.
Il modo in cui viviamo, e specialmente i giovani, hanno bisogno di modelli di persone che ci mostrino come far emergere il meglio di noi stessi, per mettere a frutto i doni e i talenti donati da Dio e nel fare questo indicare la via per un futuro migliore per le nostre società.
At the end of the meeting, there was no shortage of gifts and laughter. He received this autographed helmet and this personalized jersey.
And finally, the news, June 23rd is the 8th annual Global Rosary Relay, hosted and planned by WorldPriest Apostolate. 125 shrines in 63 countries throughout the world are participating. The rosary is being said in support of priestly vocations and the sanctification of priests. This year, shrines in Japan, Korea, Pakistan, Sweden, Iceland, and 20 other locations are participating for the first time. In addition to the scheduled rosary time slot, each shrine can hold other events such as Mass or Adoration. The founder of the apostolate, Marian Mulhall, sends each shrine information on how to pray during the relay. She mentions what time the shrine needs to begin the rosary in order for it to be taken up by the next location and continue throughout the world. The rosary started at midnight GMT time in Seoul, South Korea, ends in Hermosillo, Mexico, at the Shrine of the Divine Child Jesus. Worldwide, the apostolate asked people to pray a special intention for Pope Francis at 6 p.m. Rome time. Well, that is all the information we have for you at this time. I'm Kevin Nelson. Don't forget, you can keep up to date on Catholic news throughout the week with Catholic Newsbreak right here on the Catholic TV Network.